You need us.
So worried.
Silence is lonely.
We didn't know where you'd come.
We're here to help you.
Don't worry. You can trust us.
Trust us.
There's a way in.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there.
Listen to us.
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a girl, isn't she? So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She
did.
I'm glad we're back. She's so clever. Back. Go on. Go up. Go up. Go up into the mountain.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature.
What is it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
Don't go in. Don't.
Turn back. Turn back. It's too dangerous. What's it?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
It's me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do
you see them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld. he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll have to go under.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir.
You killed us. You killed us.
lighting the torch.
It's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the torch. Anywhere without your light. Take the torch and move. Blood.
She has it.
She did it. She's done it. Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? There are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zimbel, could see the monster in her.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Torch is going out. No, it's not. Come on, Elsie. She hasn't got much time. It's going to burn out. She's too slow. It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
Stay with light. Stay fit.
They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Suffered as a child at the hands of your father, Zin, though you pined for Dillian.